Live on Superstation TBS, this is Fort Bragg, North Carolina, the home of the 82nd Airborne Division. And in the finals of the World Tag Team Title Tournament, it will be the Midnight Express and the Freebirds later tonight.
Let me just say one thing about what happened with the Samoa SWAT team. The Midnight Express have never asked for any help from anybody, but we're smart enough to take a little when it comes along and capitalize on an advantage, and that's what we did. And, Paulie, that's what I told you we were going to do, win one way or another. Now, the fabulous Freebirds. Michael Hayes, you talk about how many girls you got, how many bras you... These guys here in the Army know more about bras than Michael Hayes will ever dream of. And I've seen the women the Freebirds go out with. If the Midnight Express ever woke up next to one of them, they'd gnaw their arm off at the shoulder just to escape without waking the beast up. But tag team wrestling, the Freebirds, the Midnight Express, probably the two most legendary names in the history of tag team wrestling. The Freebirds, 10 years ago, were the sensation. The Midnight Express, for the past 5 years, we've never met. Well, this time, the first one is going to the Midnight Express. We're going to be the World Tag Team Champions, and I'm going to be right here to make sure the third Freebird doesn't interfere in that match.
Thank you very much, Jim Cornette's comments, ladies and gentlemen. And right now, before we have more wrestling action, let's hear from the governor of the great state of North Carolina. Here's Governor Jim Martin.
Hello, I'm Jim Martin, governor of North Carolina. Today is Flag Day, as well as the 214th birthday of the United States Army. As Americans, we're all proud of the young men and women who sacrificed to serve our country. And we in North Carolina are particularly proud and honored that Fort Bragg, one of this nation's outstanding military installations, is located here in our great state. All of us are grateful for the job our young people are doing all around the world, especially at this time in our history. And a special thanks to Superstation TBS for tonight's live telecast. We're happy you chose Fort Bragg in North Carolina to mark today's celebration.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is for the World Television Championship. In the ring, the challenger from Pecos, Texas, 249 pounds, Wild Bill Irwin. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Venice Beach, California, weighing 265 pounds, he is the World Television Champion.
And the Stinger respecting that leather bullwhip of Wild Bill Irwin.
Jim, you can't blame him for that. Wild Bill right out of the Wild West. And with that bullwhip, boy, he can do some damage with that, some permanent damage.
I'll tell you what, Bob, this place is so noisy. It's like when the 1st Battalion, 82nd Aviation Brigade flew over, and those five AH-64 Apache Attack helicopters coming on the air. It was rumbling. It's rumbling now. The Stinger takes him down. Displeased, I should say. He is displeased with the top 10 ratings. Didn't want to make an appearance. Very upset. Irwin trying to upset the Stinger here. Irish whips him in. Big knee right to the midsection. Irwin has everything to gain in this one, Bob, and absolutely nothing to lose.
You're talking about a quick rise in the NWA. Here's a man who has had it. Wild Bill Irwin. And I tell you, he proved that he deserved it too, Jim. He's a rough, tough competitor all the way. He can get in and mix it up with the best.
Sting has had his share of problems in recent weeks with one Terry Funk. While on the other hand, there you see T-shirt, our big Great American Bash pay-per-view event comes up on Sunday, July 23rd, Glory Days from Baltimore, Maryland, the Baltimore Arena. That event will surely be a complete sellout. I advise the fans in Baltimore to get their tickets as early as possible. Great seats are still available right now, by the way. And Wild Bill Irwin, not selling anything right now as far as tickets. He's selling those right hands and nailing the Stinger with it.
Well, and he's making every one of them pay. He's landing them hard and he's landing them heavy.
Sting, that was a great move there to counter, to come off the ropes for that man from Venice Beach, California. As I said, he has got a tremendous issue going right now with one Terry Funk. Sting did not like the way that Funk degraded the world's champion, Ric Flair. We'll be hearing from the Nature Boy in our next segment.
Champion of his hour of glory in Nashville, Tennessee, and I don't think wrestling fans anywhere will ever forget that and what he did and what happened.
You hear the crowd chanting, Sting, Sting. They want him to fire up, get back on the offensive attack here in this battle for the television championship. I know it's Terry Funk that Sting would like in the ring, but Ricky Steamboat has Funk later tonight. It's the Stinger Splash. The Stinger held himself. Irwin catches him in midair.
I think Sting had to be surprised by that move. Irwin, who is big and strong, he just caught Sting, jerked him right out of the air.
That bear hug slam, Sting's in trouble. Irwin not capitalizing on that great offensive move, Bob.
He had Sting down, he had him in trouble. He should have gone right to the attack. He backed away. He went over the glute.
He went to get the whip, but that got him one, two, and three. Championship.
And it was a big mistake on the part of Wild Bill Irwin, too. Look at that bullwhip as he's got it up above his head there. It's back to Sting, and there was the payoff.
The Stinger splashed from behind. He nailed him with it, rolled him up in a wrestling cradle, and this one is history. And fans will be back. With Rick and Ric Flair, after you see this from Scott Gator Hall.
Orlando, Florida, introducing Scott Hall.